don't know if you can hear that on camera, but it sounds like they're burying a body. I don't think they are, though, but you never know. You know, because it's new, it's fresh, it is kind of irritated, like me sometimes. Let's grab this brush. Oh, why is everything flying? Hello, my nestlings, and welcome to another installment of, I don't know, another video of me. So yeah, my eyebrows kind of match what's going on here, because yeah, let's kind of talk then about the bumblebee in the room. Let me zoom out a tad so you can see it a bit better. So yeah, this happened yesterday. So it is still a little bit red and it is shiny because I oiled it. Yeah, kind of. I smeared it in. And yeah, it's, you know, because it's new, it's fresh, it is kind of irritated, like me sometimes. But yeah, I'm very, very happy with it. And so I kind of wanted to chat about that a little bit. And I wanted to put on some new makeup and just have a little bit of fun. I have already done my eyebrows, as you can see. Or at least I think you can see. Oh, they're a little bit bushy. So apparently it's a similar vibe or something. And what I've actually been doing lately is I have some concealer that I put on the top here and then around my brows. Just a tad to yeah, make sure that I can kind of do my brows without having to mess them up later with foundation, you know. And also, yeah, the eye bases that I have aren't green. So, also there's that. What the eye base do I want to use? Shall we for funsies use the ABH one again? Because I haven't in a while. So let's do that. I have some new stuff as well. Because 5050 Makeup sent me a PR package with some of their new releases. And I want to play with that. So yeah, what did they send me? They sent me the revamped Aphrodite palette, Aphrodite number 2. And fun fact, the outer artwork she actually designed herself. So yeah, I also swatched the palette. So swatching wise, the mattes swatch nice. Nothing wrong with them. I do think that this is a formula that will perform much better with a brush than just finger swatching. The shimmers though, they are so buttery smooth. They are also so, so pretty. It is way more colorful than you would think when you look at it in the palette, or at least that's my experience. Very, very pretty, and I cannot wait to see how they perform with a brush. And yeah, if I look at the colors, because I kind of want this, is just, this is so, 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 so pretty, that shade. It's the shade Eros. Oh, yummy. I want to use that one. Yeah, so yeah, she also sent me a highlighter. And I have the shade Quartz. The component is very nice and sturdy. It is plastic, but it doesn't feel cheap. So I hadn't swatched that one on camera yet, but let me. It is a little bit of a flakier formula. But it's very blinding. It's very icy though. So I don't know if it will be the correct shade for me. However, I am going to try it because I want to see it on my face. And they have, I think, 5 different colors. Oh darn, the cart is downstairs. But I think they have 5 different colors. If I'm not mistaken, the palette retails for 22.50 euros. The highlighters a little over 10, I believe. And she also sent me one of the new Prism shadows, which is basically a pressed multi-chrome. And when I'm looking at the ingredients of this one, it contains silicon dioxide, and that's the only silicony that I can find. I need to swatch this for you though, because the shift in this, I try to show it on camera, but it is just almost impossible. It is a green, purple, brown. Let's see if we can kind of capture it on camera. So you have the green, you also have brown, and you have a dark purple or hot pink. I can see it in the hot pink in the mirror. Let's see if I can capture it on camera. Is that it? No, but it's basically the same kind of hot pink as this one. So it's very, yeah, I can see it in the mirror, but maybe if I turn like that, can you see it now? Is it then shifting to pink? I hope so. It's so, so pretty. So yeah, I cannot wait to smear that on the face. So that's what I'm going to use newness wise. And maybe I will pull in some new lippies that I have as well. But what I also wanted to do is kind of show you the old Aphrodite versus the new Aphrodite. Because the old Aphrodite was actually, when they released When they started, they released two eyeshadow palettes, the Aphrodite and the Desert. Now, I do have the revamped Desert here. I did not get the original Desert. I did get, however, the original Aphrodite, and I have it here. So, yeah, you can see the difference. So, this is how they started. No mirror, but I don't mind that. A 9-pan palette. And then you can see the pinks are the mattes. Then you have a bunch of shimmers. And then you have two glitter shades as well. But it was a very limited palette because you only had two pink mattes. So, every time that I used the palette, I basically had either a pink crease or one that was a little bit more orangey. Yeah, and in this one, you just get more options. But I can see where it's coming from, you know? So, let me do this. And kind of check if I'm holding them up correctly in camera. So you can really see the inspiration. And it is truly a revamped one. Oh no, not the kitty cat. It's truly a revamped palette. Now, if you want me to do a multiple looks video with the Aphrodite palette, I can. I was planning on doing one with the Desert as well. But stuff happened. So, yeah, I haven't. That is it. I have that one as well, though. So if you want me to do a multiple looks video, I will link the video that I did with the Desert palette down below. I got that. No, I bought that one, actually. I didn't get it in PR. I bought that one. So yeah, so a lot of newness. I do have an affiliate code with them. It will be listed down below. It will save you 10%. I believe it's Nikki10, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, let's just get into it because I have been rambling for over 6 minutes. Yes. Okay. I have this, well, basically the swatches on my hand, right? I kind of want to, I don't know. I kind of want to maybe, you know, a little bit of a bumblebee-esque. Oh yeah. Before, oh yeah, I also have the bumblebee brow gem in my brows because I need to. But can I not just do this and also put makeup on my face? Let me first, before I go any further, prime my eyes because, yeah, otherwise we'll be here tomorrow. So first I just kind of smear a little bit on with a brush or stipple with a brush, and then I tap over it with my fingers. And if my nails are very long, I also take a sponge, but they're okay. Okay. I could whack on some foundation, but I've been doing kind of my eyes first to help with fallout or such. So yeah, but what I wanted to say before I smear eyeshadow on, I just wanted to show you guys something. I got, when I got home yesterday, there was a very big package waiting for me at my desk downstairs. And it was a package from one of my lovely, lovely subscribers. And I've said this before, but I will say it again. I never name someone. I never say... So if you guys send me something, I will never give out your name or your Instagram or YouTube handle unless you specifically ask for it. But because I don't know if you want me to, you know? So I am not going to name... name the one who sent it to me. But suffice it to say, there was a load of vegan snacks in there, and they were very, very tasty. Yes. And she also made me something, and this is just, yeah, why do you guys always make me cry? Truly, look what she made me. Can you focus, please? Thank you. It's a bumblebee. It's just so cute. But the best part is it has a bumblebee butt. And I don't know if you can see it, but there are hairs on it, or at least the illusion of hairs, you know, and the back paws have pollen on it. It's just so cool. And when I saw this, I was like, wow, you know, on the day that I finally get my tattoo, I come home and I find this, and I'm almost tearing up as well again. It's just... yeah, you guys are the best. It's just so cool. So it's living actually here. Can I show you if I turn the camera? I think so. Let me try. Let me see if I can. Yes. Yeah, so basically, yeah, and it lives here with the alien. And I have my brow gems here as well. I have a picture of me and my son. So this is kind of my tiny area. I don't think it will focus, but it's the tiny area, and the bumblebee lives there too. So yeah. So let's do that. Fancy shit this. So yeah, it's just, you guys are the best, you know. It's just, yeah, you stop making me cry, please, because I'm a very ugly crier. Yeah. So yeah, so I cannot wait how she... Oh yeah, and obviously the tattoo artist, I don't think he has an Instagram of a YouTube channel, but he does have an Instagram page. I will link his Instagram page, and I will link the tattoo shop where he works as well. Go check him out. If you are in the Netherlands, definitely a place to check out. Not gonna lie, they have some amazing artists there. So yeah, let me get some brushes. I think I want to start with this color, which is Aries, I think. Yeah, and then basically Aphrodisia is the darker shade of Aries, I think. Oh, you can make such a nice depth, but I want to start with the shade Aries. So let's do that. Never mind. I don't think it will be a complicated look because I just want to. Yeah, I know this formula from the Desert Palette, and it is truly, truly an amazing formula. Not gonna lie. So I'm going to start with this shade. Probably deepen it up with the shade Lust. I want to play with Eros, and I actually want to play with Hymeros as well. I don't know why. I just need to. There's also a very I actually grabbed the Desert Palette. I'm going to cheat. It's my video. For this shade Havara. Because when I swatch that shade Havara, it is almost the same shade as the shade Eros, but then in a matte. And I love that. So I'm going to go to the Desert Palette for the shade Havara. Because I can. That's the only reason. It's my video. And I can do what I want to. Oh, I love this shadow so, so much. Just for this shadow alone, I will grab this palette. It's just so pretty. For my appointment, actually, of my tattoo was on my birthday, which was the 12th of February. But because of the lockdown, we had to move it. And we moved it to, well, the first opportunity that arose was yesterday, which was the 22nd of March, which is basically just after the spring equinox. So I was like, yeah, that's also a very, very good date, you know. He was very, very precise with the placement. And why am I saying that? Because I find that super important. Because, you know, it's something that a tattoo is permanent. And especially here, you know, in literal plain sight, it needs to be optically straight, you know. Because this is actually, I looked up the Bumblebee pictures with my dad a while back, and the card that is basically plastered there is actually from an existing picture of a bumblebee. If I can find the picture of the bumblebee, I will show it to you. I have shown the picture of the card a few times, but I can plaster it somewhere on the screen. You know, because it is a picture of a true bumblebee. A true bumblebee is it's an animal. You know, it's not truly symmetrical. Some parts are bigger than others, so one of the wings is bigger than the other wing, and one of the paws is longer than the other paw. And we were just, you know, it's just the way it is. It's not supposed to be truly symmetrical because it's an animal, so, or an insect animal, I don't care. Yeah, to deepen it up, I'm going to go to the shade Aries, which is this one, which is the same tone but a little bit more, a little deeper, a little bit warmer. I like this. Yeah, placement wise, it was kind of a thing before it was there where I cannot talk, where it needed to be. So that took, I think, 45 minutes. But I'm so happy that he just took the time to make sure that the placement was the way that it needed to be, because we were almost not the final placement, but the placing before that. I looked in the mirror and I was like, there's something wrong with it, but I don't exactly know what. What was wrong with it is that it needed to be tilted. I think it was about a millimeter like that, and then it was good. Yeah. So, and then when he did that, I was like, yeah, this is the placement. This is it. If you have been tattooed, especially if you have been tattooed by different artists, you know that some are softer tattooers than others almost. And he felt, for me at least, very, very soft. Also the placement. One of you asked on Instagram or said on Instagram is probably a very painful a place. For me it wasn't. You see the one that I have here, there, wasn't painful at all. My basically nasty spots are the, I think they're called tendons, right, in English. It's basically you have your muscle and then you get that white part of the muscle that attaches to the bone. I think it's called a tendon. I think. Yes, those are my weak spots. If they tattoo on top of that, it hurts like a mother effer. But there weren't a lot. Yeah, here some. So on his butt, there were some spots that I was like, I don't really like that much. But overall, it was actually, yeah, it was all good. I'm going to go to the shade Lust, which is the darkest brown. Let's grab this brush. Oh, why is everything flying? Bumblebee, yes. Where is the brush that I want? Here's the brush that I want. So I'm going to go to the shade Lust, which is this one. And actually, normally, if I do kind of a first impression, I don't switch between palettes. But because the formula is exactly the same. That's better. Is exactly the same on both palettes. I don't mind it too much. And truly, I just wanted to use that shade because I can. So I'm just following my eyelid up. And then that is going to be the focus, so that I don't drag it down too much, you know. Then I'm going to go to a different brush for the shade Lust again, and I'm going to deepen it up a bit. These two palettes though, the Desert and the Aphrodite, are very, very well combinable. Yes, bad English, I'm well aware. Oh, I'm going to like this look so much. I hear a kitty cat. Hello, my darling. Is this handy? Probably not. But I have a kitty cat here, which will correspond very well with the shade Eros that I'm going to use later. So yeah, so my oh, there he is. So my appointment started 11 o'clock in the morning, and I was home around dinner time. What was it? 4:30? I think 4:30 p.m. We exited the shop, and then I was completely done. All tattooed and smeared in and covered and pictures taken and all that. So let's try it dry. I am all over the place, I'm well aware. Let's try the multi-chrome, and I have the shade 50. You can also remove this one because it is a magnetic component. Let's see how it will pick up with this brush. Okay, so when I do it and use it like this, it's more of a topper. So I am going to spray. And I have basically loaded up my brush and then sprayed the brush. And then that green shines through a little bit more. Wow, I really cannot talk today. And I actually think that because I am... Oh yeah, I can see... I don't know if you can see the pink shift when I turn my eye. But I think that if I were to combine this with the pink shades that are in here, in the palette, the pink will shine through very, very well. It's very pretty. I like it. Okay. I want to know how it behaves on top of a glitter primer. So I'm grabbing my NYX glitter primer. Tiny bit on the brush. And I'm going to put it here. Okay. And then this shade. Now it picks up better. It sticks to the brush better. Oh wow, that's a nice difference. It's basically the same. When I sprayed it, it was kind of the same thing. But I never go into a shadow with a wet brush unless it is a loose shadow. So if you use a glitter primer, it sticks to the brush nicely. So it's almost like you pick up maybe a little bit more. You can use it with a finger as well. You can use it just sprayed, you know, without glitter primer. And it is very pretty then as well.
Why is my boob itching? I don't know.
Never mind. I still want to use the shade Eros, or do I want the shade Scallop in the... No, I want the shade Eros, yes, which was my original idea. It's dry, but I want it in the inner corner. I so just want to use this shade because it's so, so pretty. Well, that actually kind of combines nicely. It's dry though. Here I have a little bit of glitter primer, I think, in the inner part, but... The way that these shimmers feel, is they are very nicely used dry as well. You can spray them, you can use them on top of a glitter primer. Oh, this is very cutesy. What do I want to do for the bottom? I could do pink bottom. Maybe pink bottom will be fun. Let's see if I have pink bottom pencil. So I will tell you in a minute what I have. It's a pencil from Essence, I believe. This is an electric vibes liner in the shade No Regrets from Essence. Where's that brush? I'm going to go into the Desert palette, the shade Rose, which is the hot pink. And I'm going to stamp that on a lower left hand. I don't know, I was kind of thinking maybe I can do a bumblebee inspired look, but I think it's more of along the lines of a dragonfly, which is also good. Do I have kind of a pinker, pinky, I can use this one, but it's not really pink though, but I can. So that's the shade called Scallop. Or do I want... No, I actually think I want the shade Urania, and this one. So let me get my glitter primer. I'm going to stamp that on my lower lash line, basically underneath the hairs. Then I'm going to go into that duochrome shade again and just put that on top. Oh, that's nice. I think I was talking about my tattoo artist, wasn't I? So basically, yeah, I don't remember. Basically, he is, how long was he tattooing for? 2 years or something like that? But his skill level and his talent and just his eye for everything. And he is one of those tattoo artists that really gets in the zone, you know, when he's working. It's just, yeah, so cool. So cool to see. I think this is almost it for the eyes. Do I want to deepen up the outer corner a tad? I can. If I can find a brush that I want to use for that. Yes, let's get a pencil brush. I'm going to go back into the shade Lust, the darker shade. And I'm just going to darken up the outer corner a bit. Make sure that the shape is the way that I want it. Because I need to go to the store later and I want to look fabulous. I know I always look fabulous, but still. So yeah, this is it for the eyes so far. Yes, what do I want to do? I want to clean up the face and I want to do liner lashes. So let me do liner lashes and the base. And then, yeah, I will be back. I can try the highlighter. What else do I have new? And I have some new lippies somewhere. So let me kind of make sure that I'm ready for that. And I also need to pee, so... Let me all do all that and I will be right back. It's too much information. Okay. A lippy I have on is from Juvia's Place in the shade Muted, combined with a lip pencil from e.l.f. Retro Paradise in, I think it's Nude 3. I think it's the darkest one of that set. Falses are from Essence, the Like a Boss lashes in Unique, and the rest will be listed down below. Well, basically the only thing I have left is highlighter. So let me get highlighter brushes. I have two. I have one from Sigma and one from Nabla that I like to use. I also put it in my inner corner though. Let's start with a fluffy brush because I don't know. It's kind of a flaky formula. So let's see. Ooh, very glittery. Okay. Let's buff it in a bit. It's a very, very glittery highlighter, at least with this brush. It is almost too light for me though. Because it's too a little bit too icy. It kind of emphasizes texture a little bit. I don't mind it too much though. Okay, let's see the other side with a stiffer brush. And I did tap off my brush. I like this a little bit better for me. It's not the highlighter look I go for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put blush over it. So I have here highlighter or blush from Odin's Eye in the shade Sweet Peach. I'm just going to buff it over. That's a bit better because I need to warm it up a bit. Or something. It's just a tad too icy for my liking. The formula is nice though. As I said, it is a glittery formula. But you can buff it out very, very nicely. I prefer it with a denser brush, me personally. It does emphasize texture a little bit, as I said, but you know, a lot of highlights do, not gonna lie. It is a little bit more highlightery than I usually go for, but that is okay. I do like the formula. So yeah, I'm just going to see. I know that she has other shades, so I'm going to see if there is one a little bit more suited to my preferences and my skin tone. That is it. And then here is, the finished look. I like it a lot. So let's go over everything that was new that I used, which was basically the eyeshadow palette. Yeah, so let's start with the eyeshadow palette. Yeah, it's, I love the formula. I like the color story as well. Especially when I swatch it out, it is more vibrant and more colorful than when you look at it. Well, basically than when you look at it. I like the fact that she put a pop of blue in here. And I like the, I like that there is a blue, a purple, and then some neutral tones and some pinker tones. But the neutral tones all have a yellow or a warmness in there. I think the palette complements itself very, very well. I think that she did an amazing job. I love the artwork that she did. I think that the formula is really, really nice as well. Yeah, and that's it. Do I think it's worth the money? Yeah, I do. If it hadn't been sent to me in PR, I would have bought it. Same as I did with the Desert palette. Which is, let me show you the Desert palette then again. This is the Desert, which is, let me hold them up side by side, which is a lot more neutral. So, but they do complement each other very well. So I did use a shade from this one from the Desert, the yellow matte I used from the Desert. The rest is the Aphrodite palette. But yeah, as you can see, they work very, very well together. Because the two purpley shades from the Desert palette go very, very well with the Aphrodite. So yeah, as a whole, yeah, again, I think that they complement each other very, very well. And I think that the formula is very, very nice. Definitely worth checking out and worth the price, in my opinion. Then yeah, this multi-core, I need more of these. I need more of these shades, but because it's so pretty. And then yeah, the green with the purple and the on the eyes, it's just so, it's so yummy, and it complements the palette so well. Now again, this is shade 50 that I have here. I know that she has more shades, so I'm going to check that out as well. And then the highlighter, it's a glittery, a little bit more of a flaky formula. To be quite honest with you, I prefer her old formula, because that was a formula that was smoother. And that is a formula that I personally prefer. A highlighter that is a bit more smooth. Instead of... is it chunky? Not really. Instead of a little bit more glittery. I think that is it. You can buff it out very, very nicely. Again, I prefer it with a denser brush. It emphasizes texture a hint, especially if you use it with a fluffier brush. But as you can see here, you can shine to the gods if you want to. It's a very nice formula to work with. It's just personal preference that I prefer a formula that's a bit smoother. It could also be the color, because this is a white highlighter or white silvery one, and it's usually not a highlighter color that I pick out for myself. There's nothing wrong with that though. I do want a highlighter that is a bit more in the tone that I prefer. So maybe a little bit more peachy even. So I'm going to see if she has one of those. But yeah, that's it. So do I think that everything is worth it? Yes, I do. I do. That's it for the first impression of the new goodies that I use. Let me know down below if you have any of these. If you're interested, let me know if you want to do multiple looks with the Aphrodite palette. I think I will, because I think it's fun. But I do have to say, quite honestly, I have quite a bit to go through. So let me know if you want me to do a multiple looks video. Because if you do want me to do a multiple looks video with this palette, I will put it on the filming list. Otherwise, I will still do it, but it will take a little bit of time. This palette is new to their collection. It has released on the 23rd of March, which has been already. And yeah, as I said in the beginning, you can use my code if you want to save 10%. I do make a small commission on that. So yeah, that is it for me today. The rest of the makeup that I have on my face will be listed down below, as will my tattoo artist. I don't know if he's watching this, it doesn't really matter. But Thomas, thank you so much for the gorgeous tattoo that you gave me. And yeah, I cannot wait for our next appointment. Do go check him out on Instagram, and yeah, also check out the shop, because they have more artists. If you live here in the Netherlands and you're not too far away from us, go visit them if you want a new tattoo, because it's definitely, definitely worth it. That is it for me. Yes, I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. Oh yeah, and yes, obviously a huge thank you for my tiny bumblebee. I love it so, so much. And it has a special place here. That was it, guys. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.